This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Jerusalem Post is a broadsheet newspaper based in Jerusalem, publishing only English and French editions. It was founded in 1932 by Gershon Agron as the Palestine Post and changed its name in 1950 to the Jerusalem Post in 2004. The paper was bought by Merkai Tikshoret, a diversified Israeli media firm controlled by investor Eli Azur in April 2014. Eli Azur acquired the newspaper Maariv, formerly regarded as left-wing. The paper underwent a noticeable shift to the right in the late 1980s. From 2004, under then editor-in-chief David Horovitz, the paper took a more centrist position, competing against the staunch left liberal Haaretz. Its former editor Steve Lind aimed to provide balanced coverage of the news along with views from across the political spectrum, focusing on Israel, the Middle East, the Jewish world and interfaith relations. In April 2016, Lind stepped down as editor-in-chief and was replaced by Yaakov Katz. Contents: 1 History 11-1925, 1950, 111-1948 Bombing 12-1950 Present 121 Ownership changes. Two notable contributors: 3 websites, 31 J Postcom, 32 J Post TV Daily News, 4 editors, 5 references, 6 external links. History 1925-1950 An antecedent paper. The Palestine Bulletin was founded in January 1925 by Jacob Landau of the Jewish Telegraphic Agency. It was owned by the Palestine Telegraphic Agency, which was in practice part of the JTA even though it was legally separate on 1 November 1931. Editorship of the Bulletin was taken over by American journalist Gershon Agronsky, later Agron, in March 1932. A dispute arose between Landau and Agronsky, which Agronsky resolved to settle by establishing an independent newspaper. However, Landau and Agronsky instead came to an agreement to transform the Bulletin into a new jointly owned newspaper. Accordingly, the Palestine Bulletin published its last issue on 30 November 1932, and the Palestine Post, incorporating the Palestine Bulletin, appeared the following day, 1 December 1932 on 25 April 1933, the masthead was reduced to just the Palestine Post, though the newspaper continued to state its founding year as 1925 for at least a year afterwards. The 16 May 1948 edition of the Palestine Post. During its time as the Palestine Post, the publication supported the struggle for a Jewish homeland in Palestine and openly opposed British policy restricting Jewish immigration during the Mandate period. According to one commentator, Zionist institutions considered the newspaper one of the most effective means of exerting influence on the British authorities. 1948 Bombing. On the evening of 1 February 1948, a stolen British police car loaded with half a ton of TNT pulled up in front of the Jerusalem office of the Palestine Post. The driver of a second car arrived a few minutes later, lit the fuse and drove off. The building also contained other newspaper offices, the British press censor, the Jewish settlement police, and a Haganah post with a cache of weapons. Arab leader Abd al-Qadir al-Husayni claimed responsibility for the bombing, but historian Uri Milstein reported that the bomb had been prepared by the Nazi-trained Fazi el-Kutub, known as the Engineer, and that two British Army deserters were also involved, Corporal Peter Mersden and Captain Eddie Brown. 3 persons died in the bombing, a newspaper typesetter and 2 people who lived in a nearby block of flats. Dozens of others were injured and the printing press was destroyed. The morning paper came out in a reduced format of 2 pages, printed up at a small print shop nearby. 1950 present. In 1950, 2 years after the State of Israel was declared, the paper was renamed the Jerusalem Post. The broadsheet newspaper is published from Sunday to Friday, with no edition appearing on Saturday, the Jewish Sabbath, and Jewish religious holidays. Regular opinion columnists write on subjects such as religion, foreign affairs, and economics. As of 2016, the managing editor is David Brin. Some of the material is translated and included in the free Hebrew daily Israel Post, of which Eli Azur is a co-owner. In January 2008, the paper announced a new partnership with the Wall Street Journal, including joint marketing and exclusive publication in Israel of the Wall Street Journal Europe. The Jerusalem Post also publishes a monthly magazine titled Ivrit, edited by Dr. Sarat Yalev. Its target audience is people learning Hebrew language, and it is described as an easy Hebrew publication, meant for improving basic Hebrew reading skills. It uses the vowel notation system to make comprehension of the Hebrew alphabet abjad simpler. The Jerusalem Report, edited by Ilan Evyatar, is a fortnightly print and online glossy news magazine. Ownership changes. Until 1989, the paper supported the forerunners of the Labour Party. In 1989, the paper was purchased by Hollinger Inc. A number of journalists resigned from the Post after Conrad Black's takeover and founded the Jerusalem Report, a weekly magazine eventually sold to the Post. The leader of the walkout was David Landau, who founded the Haaretz English edition and went on to become editor-in-chief of Haaretz until 2009 under editor-in-chief David Makovsky. From 1999 to 2000, the paper took a centrist position. In 2002, Hollinger hired the politically conservative Bret Stephens of the Wall Street Journal as editor-in-chief. David Horowitz, who holds a center-left worldview, took over as editor-in-chief on 1 October 2004. He was expected to have the paper eschew any clear political line, and the paper turned centrist again on 16 November 2004. Hollinger sold the paper to Merkai Tikshoret Limited, a Tel Aviv-based publisher of Israeli newspapers. Canwest Global Communications, Canada's biggest media concern, had announced an agreement to take a 50% stake in the Jerusalem Post after Merkai bought the property, but the deal soured. The two sides went to arbitration, and Canwest lost in 2011. Horowitz was succeeded by the paper's former managing editor, Steve Lind, who aimed to retain the paper's political moderation and balance. Yaakov Katz succeeded Lind in 2016. Notable contributors: Khaled Abu Toma, Amatz Asa L. Gershon Baskin, Alon Ben Meir, Shmuley Botich, Erwin Kotler, Alan Dershowitz, Yael Eckstein, Shave Israel, Caroline B. Glick, Warren Goldstein, Yaakov Katz, Erb Kynan, Issy Liebler, Melanie Phillips, Shmuel Rabinowitz, Jonathan Rosenblum, Martin Sherman, Gil Troy. Websites: JPostcom. JPostcom was launched in December 1996. Its current version also contains a French language edition, FriPostcom, blogs, an e-paper version of the daily newspaper, a range of magazines, and other web versions of the group's products. According to Alexa Internet Traffic Rankings, JPostcom is among the top 3,000 websites in the United States. The site is an entity separate from the daily newspaper while sharing reporters. It is managed by different teams. Its staff is based in Tel Aviv, while the newspaper offices are located in Jerusalem. The site contains archives that go back to 1989, and the default search on the site sends users to archive listings, powered by ProQuest, where articles can be purchased. Free blurbs of the article are available as well, and full articles are available when linked to directly from navigation within JPostcom or from a search engine. JPostcom includes the Premium Zone, a paywall-protected area, containing additional Jerusalem Post articles and special features. The site, which was given a graphic facelift in September 2014, recently relaunched its mobile and tablet applications, as well as its special edition for mobile viewing, JPost TV Daily News. In May 2013, JPostcom launched an online daily newscast, which goes out every weekday. The edition is anchored by Canadian-Israeli journalist Lauren Izzo, who previously attended Ryerson University's School of Journalism and is frequently featured in Anglo-Israeli media. Each newscast is aired around 5 p.m. Israel time, GMT. Two editors: Gershon Agron, 1932-1955, Ted Lurie, 1955-1974, Lee Ben-Dor, 1974-1975, Ari Rath and Erwin Frenkel, 1975-1989, N. David Gross, 1990-1992, David Bar-Ilan, 1992-1996, Jeff Barak, 1996-1999, David Makovsky, 1999-2000, Carl Schrag, 2000, Jeff Barak, 2000-2002, Bret Stephens, 2002-2004, David Horowitz, 2004-2011, Steve Lind, 2011-2016. Yaakov Katz, 2016. Present: Israel Portal, Jerusalem Portal, Journalism Portal. References: Carat, ABC, Jerusalem Post, Encyclopedia Judaica, 2007. 2012. Colonial Copyright, Intellectual Property in Mandate, Palestine, Oxford University Press. Carat, AB. Anat Balint, JLEM. Post: Change of Editors. Archived 8 April 2016 at the Wayback Machine, Haaretz, September 5, 2004. Carat Post, Jerusalem. Canwest loses battle for 50% of Jerusalem Post. Hibeamcom. Retrieved 8 June 2013. 21 November 2013. Yedioth Aharonoth, Business Calculus. Globes. The Marker. Religious Beshiva. Hamodia. Makor. Rishon. Yated. Naaman. Non-Hebrew Courier. Russian. Al-Ittihad. Arabic. The Jerusalem Post. English. Kul. Al-Arab. Arabic. Al-Madina. Arabic. Vesti. Russian Local. Higher Tel Aviv Kol Higher Jerusalem Yediath Tel Aviv Tel Aviv Z-Man Tel Aviv Tel Aviv Defunct Al-Hamishmar Devar Di Woch Habakar Hadashat Hamashkif Hatzai Hazit Ham Harut Israel Shtim Israel Nakrikan Israeli Kol Ham. Lamerhav Uj Kelet Waka Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 184,688,249 GND, 4,353,146-5 BNF, CB 13570266 C data.